I'm already feeling my balls on fire.
What up, deviants? Welcome back to another video. So first time in my life ever, I'm riding a Ducati. Thanks to my buddy Abhiram riding my 10RR there. So he owns this 899 Panigale. This Italian beauty. So I'm very excited to be trying out a Ducati for the first time, because I have zero experience with the Ducati. Just take a look at this bike. Beautiful it's looking, man. 899 Panigale. For all the pics, you have to head out to my Instagram page at deepu.vlogs. One beauty of a machine this thing is. Let's go. Okay, that's the kill switch. Holy moly, that is so loud. God damn, bro. It's too damn loud. Let's kill it. I haven't left anything there. This bike feels so light. Gotta be very careful. So initial feelings, I'm already feeling this bike is too difficult to ride, because the seat is so small, man. It is kind of pushing you on the tank. So for big people like me, it will be extremely difficult to ride this bike for long. Maybe I can do a short spin or something without any issues, but anything longer than 1 hour, I think this bike is very troublesome. Power is insane, no doubt about it, because of the L-twin engine. So I'm feeling like I'm riding an RC390. It's almost exactly the same seating posture, except that this thing is a lot more powerful and it is heating up a lot. I'm already feeling my balls on fire. So that's the problem with Ducati. Everybody keeps telling me it heats up a lot, man. High compression, L-twin, even the V4, they heat up extreme. So I'm not on a highway to belt the bike like how it's supposed to be ridden, but that's still okay, man. Nowadays I'm seeing many people who are annoyed with my speeding stuff. I don't know, they feel like I'm gonna die. Come on, bro, I'm not doing like extremely high speeds like I used to before. Maybe 120, 140 max, and you're still pissed with 120, 140, I don't know what to say. These bikes, if you're keeping it in 6th gear, they'll already be in 120, 140 easily, without you doing anything. So I don't know how you can expect me to ride anything slower than that. But I have to tell you, this bike is too nimble. That's mainly because this construction is very sleek, and the lightweight adds up to the extreme handling of this bike. But the seating is hell, man. The seat cushioning is too hard. So they have taken the name track bike literally and made this bike. So it's only best suited for track. Road usage is highly difficult. Quick shifter is working fine. So if you didn't know, this bike has quick shifter, no auto blipper though. And for a stock exhaust, this bike is too loud, bro. What is wrong with that guy, man? Overtaking wrong way. This bike roars, that's for sure. But pushing it too hard, maybe it will slightly feel unstable. I don't know. Mine is the first time on a Ducati, so probably I have to get used to the characteristics of this bike. But I noticed that if you want to go fast, then it starts to shake. I mean, not the handlebars or anything, the rear gets lighter. But right now, for my wrist conditions, this bike will be a proper exercise because I am exerting too much weight on my wrist. So anyways, my wrist does not bend backwards. I mean, not completely yet. So if I keep riding this bike day in and day out, probably it will force my wrist to go backwards. So there's Abhiram on my ZX10 RR. Look at that beautiful bike. Oh, he's telling ZX10 RR is awesome. So for my first ride on a Ducati, I like the bike. I'll be frank with you. Doesn't matter if it's too aggressive to sit or it's too hot to handle. I still don't care, man. These are performance bikes, man. Come on. What can you expect? So they will have their own character that you may not like. But still, that's how they are. You want a bike to be fast, you want a bike to perform, then this is how it will be. So these are proper race machines. So maybe next time I'll test this bike on a highway, so that way I can test the, you know, handling, acceleration and all that. So these are small roads. So let's see, maybe some other day we'll get a chance to ride a Ducati again on a highway. But again, the seating is exactly like the RC390. The seat is small, narrow, and it's pushing you towards the handlebars. It feels exactly like the RC390. And damn, it vibrates a lot, bro. My hands are going numb already. Especially if you're in low speeds like this, commuting, then you'll have tough time to hold the handlebars. It will make your hands numb. So that's about it, guys. See you on the next one. Peace.